Do you have headaches, neck issues, or shoulder discomfort from upper cross syndrome that is keeping you from doing what you want to do day in and day out? Well, stick around to the end of the video for two exercises on how to deal with this at home. Hi everyone, thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Dr. Vincenzo Romaldi. I am a chiropractor in Yorkville in downtown Toronto, and today we're going to be talking about upper cross syndrome. Now, before we get into today's video, I would just like to say that chiropractic care can help with conditions such as upper cross syndrome, but what I'm after is making sure that you're functioning optimally. So when you have a stress in your life, whether it be a physical, emotional, or chemical stress, you're dealing with it at your best. It's my sole objective, comes right from the heart. Now that said, let's get into today's video. So today we're gonna be talking about upper cross syndrome. We talked about upper cross syndrome in last video and what it was. So essentially it's a syndrome in your upper part of your body that deals with tight and weak muscles that cross over from front to back. In last video, we addressed the tight muscles and how to stretch them. Today we're gonna be focusing on the weak muscles and how to strengthen them. So what are the weak muscles we're dealing with today? So the muscles in the front part of your body or your anterior neck we're gonna be dealing with that are weak are the deep flexor muscles of your neck and the muscles in the back of your system or your posterior of your back is that are weak that we're gonna be dealing with today are your rhomboids and lower traps. So here are two exercises on how to strengthen both of those muscles. We're gonna be starting with the neck deep flexor muscles of the neck. It's a simple exercise. What we're gonna be doing for this is lying down on your back, we're gonna chin jut just a little bit to engage those muscles, and then you're lifting your head off of the table 1 to 2 centimeters and holding that. Now to increase the stability and the activation of those muscles, what you can do is push your tongue to the top palate of your mouth, the roof of your mouth, and you will feel a deeper activation of those muscles. Hold that for 10 seconds and repeat for 10 times. The second exercise that we're gonna be doing is gonna be targeting those back muscles that we talked about earlier, so your rhomboids and your lower traps. What you're gonna be doing for this is lying down on your tummy, and like we did with the other exercise, you're gonna be chin jutting, you're gonna be externally rotating your arms, opening up your chest, and then shoulders down. Now, what I like to tell patients to help them visualize a little bit better is it's almost like you're putting your shoulder blades into your back pockets. It will really help to open up the chest and engage those muscles there. And again, you're gonna be holding for 10 seconds and you wanna repeat this for 10 times. So those are two exercises in order to strengthen the weak muscles that are associated with upper cross syndrome. I hope this helps. If you do find that this helped, please leave a like and share. And if you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. If you have any suggestions on future videos or conditions that you'd like me to cover, also comment down below. I hope you have a great day and see you next video.